Okay.
So I figured while the feet are drying, I will work on the eyes. This is what I did last time. I used these little template to to draw the pupil on the eye. Oh, I got the wrong sort of pencil. Oh dear. Hang on. The cool change has come through now. I just went and opened up the house, the windows and doors to get a bit of breeze through. That's smudged there, that's a shame. Oh good, it comes off. Okay, do the other side. And I can very carefully paint that in. Whoops, I just touched the foot. It wasn't good. I've got paint now. And it's still resting. I think he's awake now. He had a big sleep before, which is the best thing to do during the heat. Just curl up and go to sleep. I think that's all right. Okay, let's do some black. Where's that paintbrush? There. Not actually. I've got these really fine ones my daughter gave me. I can't remember when. Might have been Mother's Day. I don't know if I've got the camera in close enough. Sorry if I haven't. Oops. It's hard to stay perfectly within the circle, but it's good enough. Looks a bit startled. Oh, don't touch those wet feet. Oops. I wish I hadn't used that other pencil. It smudged it quite a bit. But too late now. Alright, next. Clean the brush. Try and stop him from tipping over. Don't tip over, please. There. Stay there. It's coming a bit closer. Oh, no, now I've gone off. Is that better? Hopefully. Oh, no, don't do that. Oh, I might just put the fan back on. Need a bit of air circulation. I can't open this tub now. Oh, come on. To do here is just put little dots. And little stripes. go around the edge. I'm just looking at the other one I did just to see how to do it. Oops. Let's switch over. I'm still in green. Go on the outside first. Oh dear. Oh dear. Quick, get off. Good. I was just thinking, I had a most bizarre dream last night that I went back to my high school as an adult for a high school reunion, and when I got there I came across old friends that, you know, obviously haven't seen for many years, and yeah, it was really funny, like a group of us got together and started talking and saying how our lives were now, and you know, since we were in high school, and then all of a sudden we changed back into teenagers. And I know why a lot of that dream really stayed with me all day. It's been on my mind, and thinking about old school friends and. Amazing how vivid some things are in your dreams. They seem so real. Alright. Now I need to look at him this way. Well, he looks a bit funny. Try and do this stripe across the top of the eye. My hand's shaking a bit. Sorry, I'm having trouble holding it so that it's comfortable for me and you can possibly see what's going on. That's better. I think I covered the other side up too much. The pupil's a bit bigger, that's why. It looks very girlish. You look like a girl. Come here, see if I can wipe some off. Try that again. Oops. Oh no, it's gone all blue. What a surprise. Smudge the black too now. Well, now it really looks like a girl because I smudged the black and that looks like eyelashes. have a baby wipe. And I suppose it wouldn't matter if it looked female, but I don't want that silly cartoonish look that it's got at the moment. Typical, isn't it? You do something for yourself and it turns out okay, then you try and make something for someone else and lots of things go wrong. Never mind. I shall fix it. Just dab that dry. Now, can you see there how the eye... Hopefully you can see. And that eye looks so funny, so I'm going to have to try that again. Do the angle. No, I think it's the pupil being so big. Oh, that's a bit better. Alright. I better not try and fix it too much because I'll just make it worse. I will patch up a few spots here. I guess with today's heat, a lot of plants will be suffering out there. Hopefully my zucchinis will have grown well. They seem to really like the heat. And I noticed this morning there were a few baby ones on there, so they might be a lot bigger by the time I check on them in the morning. Move. Oh, here's a let's go toilet. I'll have to go. Okay, he's decided he wants to stay outside for a bit. It's much nicer out there now. It's a beautiful cool breeze. And yeah, it's really nice. Now, I want to put a little bit of white highlight in the eye, and I think I'll use gesso. Let's see how that works. Brush. Test that and make sure there's blue in there. Where's the other brush? Alrighty, come on. Now try and cover up that smudge a bit too. Might be a bit better. Yeah, that's better. Sorry if I'm not doing this very well for you to see. Still don't like that smudge. Gesso worked well on the black though. Alright, I'm not going to fight with that too much longer. I've wiped off some of the edging. Actually, I might let that dry. I'll start doing this again. And then I'll finish the eyes at the last minute. What about this brush? It's quite a long brush. I might use that. Just start again with the highlights, going underneath in the cracks, which, if you really think about it, they would be on top, not underneath, but I think I like that look better. It's glittery without being over the top, if you know what I mean. Hope this works out all right. Try not to smudge that eye. And this brush is a little bit funny to use. I'm not used to a long bristle like that. Take a bit of getting used to. Putting on a bit too much. I might change brushes. I don't like it that much. Choose this baby one. That's better. See if there's water drops on there. Glad that the weather's cooled down. Be better for sleeping tonight and the cooking I need to do. And it'll be nicer tomorrow. And easier for my mother. She's to drive a couple of hours to get up here to Melbourne. And she certainly wouldn't want to be doing it in that heat. She's got an old car and you don't want to risk it overheating. So yeah, it worked out well. But it's cooled down. She's had her dog, Lucy, her name is. She's a Springer Spaniel, if I haven't told you already. Couple of months now. Yeah. At first she was a little bit sort of nervous, not knowing who I was or where she was going when my mum put her in the car, but now she's used to coming here and Bandit loves her. They get on really well together, so it's nice when she comes to visit. He wags his tail like crazy. And she's got a little stumpy tail, and her little stumpy tail wags very quickly as well. She even takes over Bandit's bed. He doesn't mind. My mum brings a bed for her to sleep on, but she always prefers Bandit's bed instead. Oops. I can't remember if I've told you or not. My mum's dog is a rescue dog and she's completely deaf. So she needs to be communicate to her with hand signals, which is really good. She was obviously trained by a previous owner. Apparently the rescue people told my mum that she... Her previous owner passed away, so that's why she needed rehoming. And it seems like she probably lived near the beach, because my mum does now, and she takes her for a walk every morning down to the beach, and Lucy gets so excited, she loves it. She bounds around in the water and it's funny. It's good to see that she's happy. She's a fair older dog, not a young one. I think my mum said she's 12 years old, which is what my mum wanted. She didn't want a young dog that was going to be difficult for her to handle, because my mum's going to be 82 in June. So she thought taking on a young pup might be a bit much, but an older dog that's quiet and doesn't, you know, it's not going to cause too much problems or run off on her or anything, so it's worked out well for both of them, I think, because Lucy needed somewhere permanent. She was just with foster care before, and they had, I think, 6 other dogs, so it was a bit crowded there, and she wasn't getting the one-on-one attention that she was used to, so it's good now. My mum's got a companion with Lucy and her cat as well. She's got 2 companions. I was thinking of getting a cat, but I don't know now. I'm undecided whether I want to take on another pet. I keep going back and forth, thinking maybe I'll not get anything after Bandit goes, or I'll get a cat, and then I start thinking, oh, maybe I can't live without a dog, so I might get a dog, and then I go back to, no, I don't want anything. So I don't know what's going to happen. I know eventually when Bandit's time comes, I won't want another pet for a while. It was like that with my previous dog. I just couldn't. It would feel like I was replacing him, you know, and it just wouldn't feel right. I need that little bit of time to grieve and adjust. But I do love animals very much. And it's nice having them around. And dogs just give you so much love. They're beautiful. I think dogs are my favourite animals. I love lots and lots of animals, but dogs are just super special. Super, super special. So are pigs, mind you. Pigs are far more intelligent than dogs. And if they were allowed, they would have a greater connection and companionship with humans than a dog does, if you can imagine that. I'd love to have a pig. There's a pig online. She has her own channel, and it's Esther the Wonder Pig. Some of you might have seen stuff about her. She's spoilt. She lives with her family, and of a people family and other pets. I think they have a turkey and dogs, and she's just spoilt rotten. She has a huge bed that she sleeps on, and they feed her treats, and she's just utterly delightful. I love seeing videos about Esther. She just looks so happy. As it should be. All animals deserve to be happy and live a happy, healthy life. Just wipe that off my hands. Yeah, that's not quite as bright. Although I think I've put more on here than I have on my own bird. But never mind. Doesn't have to be the same. Gee, I love this colour, this beautiful, shiny, metallic blue. I think it would look really nice on a black background. Do a painting with it or something. I've got lots of black cardstock actually. I should do something with metallics on black because they stand out really well against the black. I suppose this video is hugely long now. I always had the idea, I'll just pop on quickly and do a little something. And it ends up going for ages. I guess because I take so long to do things. But some of you like watching it, so I'll just let it happen. I actually noticed from the amount of views that I get from most videos that I've got 43 regulars, because most of the time I get 40, on average 43 views. That's interesting. I'm going to get in there. I see a bit that I've missed. I can see a bit of white. It's not going to work. Where's that long brush? Just use anything just to cover the white up. I don't think that's going to fit in there either. Go on, go in. So I've got a gap between the feathers. In deep enough. Oh well. Bad luck. Be here all night doing that. I've been really enjoying watching Kelly Black lately. Hi Kelly, if you're watching. Love Kelly's vlogs, just seeing her little nest, as she calls it, little cottage she lives in, and all the beautiful things she has, how she's decorated it, and nice deck that she has. She feeds the birds on her deck, and little squirrels come. I love squirrels, they're so cute. So, so cute. And I like, because Callie's vegan as well, so I like seeing the food that she makes and looks really good. Always like trying out different recipes and different things, keeps it interesting. I found some amazing recipes lately. One of them I told Callie, I shared the recipe with her, is a Moroccan spice pie. Has butternut squash in it, and I added potatoes to it as well, just to bulk it out a bit more. And a lot of Moroccan style spices, and it's all sort of wrapped up in a phyllo pastry casing. It's just so nice, and it has hummus in the middle of it as well. It's a really good combination of flavors, because Moroccan quite often does the sort of sweet sour thing, fruit. Oh, not so much sour, but spicy and fruity. And this pie has that. It has cranberries and nuts, and I can't remember what else, but yeah, really, really nice. Made that a few times now. There's some really beautiful recipes that are so tasty and healthy at the same time, so it's not boring eating healthy food at all. I love lots of fresh salads as well, particularly in summer. There's some amazing salad recipes online as well. All sorts of combinations that you wouldn't think, you know, ordinarily to put certain things together. But when you try it, you just think, oh wow, why haven't I done this before? It's pretty good. Oops, it's tipping. Not too much longer, and I'll be done. Oh, some noise out there. And people bringing their rubbish bins back in. Our bin collection got delayed by one day the past 2 weeks because of Christmas and New Year Day. So instead of collecting on Friday, they've been collecting on Saturday morning. So yeah. Noisy people bringing their bins back inside. Oh, I talk about the most bizarre things, don't I? Probably don't want to know about the rubbish collection. Let's talk about whatever pops into my head. There are a few people I like watching their YouTube videos that haven't been on for quite a while. One of them's Amy Taylor. I don't know what's happened to Amy. I hope she's alright. It's been a very long time since she did videos. Right, now this part here, oh, my hand got sore holding on to that. Redundant here. I probably won't get this video done for a few days because, yeah, I've got to do the family thing tomorrow and then recuperate afterwards for a few days. And then that, just putting all the files together and editing takes a long time as well. I've got to be in the mood to do it because sometimes I just think, oh, I couldn't be bothered. This brush is really good. I like it. Very fine. I just remembered I had a birthday in November. I was going to say last month, but it's more than last month now. And I got a few crafty gifts that I forgot to show you, so I might do a separate video for that, just to show you those few things that I got, which is always lovely to have new things. Mostly my lovely daughter who buys me crafty stuff. My eldest son had a birthday last month. He's just turned 36. I can't believe I've got a 36-year-old child. Man. Unbelievable. Sometimes think to myself, how on earth did I get here? 36. Yeah. When my mum says, yes, my baby's 57. I think, oh. Still, never complain, hey? It's good to be alive. It's good to get old. I'm very grateful for that.